Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and in this video, we will be discussing the lateral compartment of the leg. And this is a smaller compartment, so this will be a shorter video, but we will be covering the similar players, which of course are the muscles, the actions they play a role in, as well as innervation. Excuse me. All right. So, again, the lateral compartment is the smallest or the narrowest compartment of the leg. In fact, when looking at a directly lateral view, which you can see here, we can see the two muscles of the lateral compartment. These are going to be the fibularis or peroneus longus, as well as the fibularis or peroneus brevis. Peroneus, you see a lot of times replacing the term fibularis. But as you can see, you can have other compartments or other muscles of other compartments as well. So you can see the tibialis anterior as well as the extensor digitorum longus muscle from the anterior compartment, as well as the soleus and the gastrocnemius, which is not labeled here, but these two are going to be part of the posterior compartment. So all this to say that you just have this relatively small region right here that is going to make up the lateral compartment. The fibularis longus, as its name would suggest, is longer and it's more superficial as well. So it's going to become more tendinous. You can see it kind of narrowing down into this tendon right here as you get more distally. The fibularis or peroneus brevis is shorter and deeper, but it's often visible right where the fibularis longus tendon is. So you can see the fibularis brevis deep to the fibularis longus tendon. The primary action of the lateral compartment is eversion. So we have the E here, the eversion of the subtalar and transverse tarsal joints. And this is going to move the sole of the foot or the plantar surface laterally. So in essence, it's elevating the lateral margin of the foot. And this makes sense because I hope at this point that you can understand if we're talking about fibularis muscles or peroneus muscles, that fibularis muscles evert, whereas tibialis muscles invert. So inversion is moving the sole of the foot more medially. The fibularis longus and brevis also play a weak role in plantar flexion or lifting the heel up and the toes down, such as when one stands on their toes. But again, I want to emphasize this is a weak role. It's that posterior compartment of the leg that's going to play the biggest role in plantar flexion. Lastly, this compartment is entirely innervated by the superficial fibular or peroneal nerve, which is one of the terminal branches of the common fibular or peroneal nerve. And you can see in this image here the common fibular nerve coming down from the popliteal fossa. It will wrap around the neck of the fibula in a fairly subcutaneous location, so less protected right around this region here to direct trauma in that region because it's right up against the bone and it's fairly subcutaneous there. But that common fibular or peroneal will give off the superficial fibular, which will supply this lateral compartment, and the deep fibular or peroneal nerve, which supplies the anterior compartment of the leg. Excellent. We have arrived at the summary slide, which is short and sweet, which makes sense for a fairly small muscle compartment. Please take time to review and always feel free to reach out with any questions. Have a great rest of your day.